As now the question, why from the first place the Oral Torah that received Moses in Sinai, he didn't write it? Why we not supposed to write the Oral Torah? After the temple was destroyed, they decide to write it.
Second temple.
The second temple was destroyed, they decide to write it, even it was not permitted to write it. It's like to do something against the Torah, against the tradition, because if not, it might be, all this knowledge will be lost in the trouble of the exile with everything happened, so they have to write it. But from the first place, it was not supposed to be written. Everybody from himself, he can write it. Let's say I want to memorize for myself a few things, so I can write it for myself. But to write it for everybody, that everybody learning from him, it was not legal to do it. Why? The reason why how to do it, it was not written, because God want the movement of it, the change, the development,
the dynamic,
the dynamics,
with the evolution of humankind.
The situation are infinite. What to do? You cannot write everything anyhow. There are always a situation that you not expect, and sometimes you have to improvise.
Make changes.
You have to use your heart, your intuition, and sometimes even to do things against the Torah, like we explained, the special commandment of Asaph. Sometimes, for the sake of guarding the Torah, we have to do things that are not permitted. For example, somebody is sick in Shabbat, we have to heal him. Even if by healing I might do a work that is not legal to do in Shabbat. All right. So there can be many examples of that. Sometimes we have to use our shikula dat, our way of judging the situation,
judgment,
and decide. It's like improvisation, you know?
Intuition?
Improvisation in music. I'm a musician. It is somebody that write a composition, a classics, all right? It's, everything is perfect. It's all written from the beginning to the end. And it is another kind of musician that he will take the structure of the composition,
structure,
and he will improvise on it.
A theme.
All right, he will do improvisation. All right, so he can be somebody that he learn, he do academics and everything, but he cannot improvise. He can write something perfect because he learned a lot, but he cannot improvise. And it's another kind of musician. The one that he will write, he will do everything exactly the way it is written, that
reproduces.
It's like a tzaddik, it's like a righteous man. And the one that he provides is like somebody that repent. He repent to the Judaism, to the religion. Right? So he have again tools, vessel of life, that the one that was all his life in a religion house,
religious
house, cannot use, cannot perform with this. It's like the end of Esav, that Yaakov don't have this quality of the end of Esav.
Hands.
To do of think. And this have to do with improvisation too. Okay, so in the moment you know, sometimes the improvisation is so good, so you write it. But in the moment you write something, in one way it's become dead. It's not life anymore.
Alive.
It's not alive anymore. It's become dead. I just have to do this and I have to do this.
Fixed,
you know, this is the way we do it, this is the way we do it, and for everything. One of the complaints of people, not religion, against the religious people,
secular,
they will say, you don't learn to think by yourself, you don't learn to take responsibility. Everything, you go to the rabbi, you cannot think by yourself. You cannot judge by yourself what is better to do. Sometimes in life, you cannot ask the rabbi, you have to take decision. In the moment everything is written, you don't learn to live as a religious person. You don't learn to improvise in the life.
To apply,
to know what exactly God wants for me, not from you. For me, in this place, in this moment.
To adapt.
It's completely a situation that never exists before and never will exist in the future. All right, so this is life. And somebody that is not religion, he learn this kind of behave in life.
Secular people, yeah.
And people that is religion, everything, he go to the book, what we have to do, what we have to do, he don't develop himself in many way. All right, so... And he's too scary of everything he do.
It's the check. It's
all right.
According to the law, yeah.
So this is a problem. So it's very important that what we do will be connected to life. In the moment you write it, it's dead.
It's like a tree of knowledge, good and evil, and tree of life?
In the moment you write that, it's like it becomes like the tree of knowledge, good and evil. What is the written Torah that causes the death?
It's like a set of laws.
All right? Why the Torah causes the death? Because the Torah, what is the tree of knowledge, good and evil, what is the written Torah? Do this, don't do this. The Torah was not connected to the tree of life. The tree of life, it's meant to life. Life has to do with change, with improvisation, with... it's nothing, it's not really fixed.
It's like the soul of the Torah.
It's like the soul of the Torah.
Zohar, Sefer HaZohar, and the Kabbalah.
Yeah.
Life.
It's life.
Love.
It's pleasure. It is will, I want to do this, and I want to do this, and I have to do this, and is life, is pleasure. Why I want to do this? Why?
Understanding. Why?
Understanding why I want to do this. Mm-hmm. Have a pleasure to doing this.
Intention.
I have a motivation to do this.
Why
and it's not something fixed. It can be changed all the time.
Using the heart.
Using the heart, using the intuition, the woman have, we say that the woman have more intuition of the man. So when God said to Adam, you cannot eat from this tree, he was shocked. Why? I could not know by myself that I cannot eat from this tree, from this fruit. It means I am defect, I am not perfect. If you create me perfect, I should know by myself that this tree, I should not eat from it. Why you have to tell me? In the moment God said to Adam, you cannot eat, it's already a problem. It means something wrong with me.
He was not able to figure it out by himself.
One, the explanation for the excuse of the man, well, you give me the woman. Why you give me the woman? She has more intuition of me. She should know what is good and what she's not with because she has heart. Right, so she told me to eat. So if she told me, it means it's all right. Right, so the woman of course, have to do with the Oral Torah, the Torah of the receiver. Right? It was
the tree of life.
Tree of life, or as well, the tree of death. What is the Oral Torah? The Oral Torah have to do with the woman. It's the Torah of the receiver. It's the Torah of the man. It's the of the righteous man of God. It's the written Torah. It's like the academy.
But you said before that the woman is linked to the...
The woman, she's linked to above and she's linked to below.
To tree of life.
But to the halacha too. To the rule. Torah Shebe'al Peh is a kingdom. Mm-hmm. The king is always female. Mm-hmm. Right? David is a head of the Oral Torah, of the Torah Shebe'al Peh.
Wow, interesting.
Of course. The speech, the kingdom is a speech. We call it the Torah of the mouth. The mouth is always female.
And Moshe is connected to the Torah, written Torah?
Moshe is a male. He's connected to the written Torah. Oh,
interesting. So you have Moshe and David.
Moshe, yeah. Am Israel, in the land of Israel, supposed to do this connection. How I realize the Torah of Moses in different situations. Moshe didn't come with us to Eretz Israel, for we can develop the concept of life, moving.
Dynamics.
Life, it's mean pleasure too. So have to do it all, it's connected to what is above the will. Okay? So, this explanation why the Oral Torah should not be written from the first place. But we go to exile, there's no other way, it was written. Still, there are always infinite way how to see the reality. And this is one of the things that the Hasidut teach.
What?
The heart.
Attributes of heart.
The Hasidut even will teach you a concept like aver gdola avera lishma mitzvah shelo lishma, a sin that is for the sake of God is bigger of a good deed that is not really with a good intention.
From our perception.
All right, so there are many movements in Hasidut, so it is a certain Hasidut that teach a lot this concept of give all kind of explanation why Yuda have to a hora, Tamar, that was a dress like a hora, and he go to her, and from this came Mashiach. All right, so they will give all kind of explanation to all kind of sin that was done in the Torah, why they was done. All right, so because the Hasidut is the Torah of the heart. And when we talk about the Hasidut of Chabad, it means the head. But we talk about the head of the heart, the logic of the heart. All Hasidut have to do with the heart, with the woman, with the female.
Chokhmah bin Adad.
Yeah.
Chabad.
Okay, so this is something general that Hasidut is to reveal the Torah of the female, of Eve. Mm. And this is what Jesus did too. He's connected to the mother, like we explained many times.
That's interesting.
All right?
Compared to the Torah of Moshe,
compared to the Torah of logic is a man, heart is a female. Mm-hmm. Okay?
Jesus more logic. Rational.
Jesus give you something that have to do with the heart.
Right.
And Hasidut, the same thing.
Mm-hmm.
Okay?
So what else can you just tell us?
So in the certain time they decide to write it. What they wrote in the beginning, it's what you call the Mishnah.
Mm-hmm.
There are six books of Mishnah.
Meaning Mishnah,
Mishnah is from the word Leshanen. Leshanen, it means to say it again and again. People used to learn this book by heart. All right, it's few books, but it's not big like the Talmud. It's that give you in a very short way. In a case like this, you do so, or you do so, and it is opinion that you do it so. In any case of this, you do it so, etc. Rule. It's the Mishnah, right? So there are six books it's a book Seder Zraim, Sid, all the commandments that have to do with Eretz Israel. It is a seder of Moadim, time, holidays, Shabbat, etc. It is a seder of Nashim, everything that has to do with family relation, etc. All right, so there are six sedarim.
Do we know when they were written, more or less?
Yes, they were signed by Yehuda Nasi in the end of 300 years. To the count of zero. In the end of the 300 years after Jesus born,
yes,
this was signed by Yehuda Anasi. And the people that did it, or we call them Tanaim. This is the time of the Tanaim.
They wrote the Mishnah.
They wrote the Mishnah. After came the time of, after a while, it's not anymore enough. You know, something that it can be very clear when you still remember all the tradition and everything. You know, let's say that you can see what is in the room. So for me to explain you what is in the room, it would be not a big deal. But let's say that you don't see anymore. Now I have to explain you what we have in the room. I want to explain you that this book is red. What is red? I have to right, so the generation after a few hundred years, we need much more explanation what really have to be done. And this is the Talmud, the Gemara, all the discussion of the Chachamim about what it is written in the Mishnah. And this is why this was signed by the Rabbi Ashi, Rav Ashi, about in the end of 500 years in Babylon. There are two Talmudim. It was a Talmud in Jerusalem, in Eretz Israel, and it was a Talmud Bavli. Here in Eretz Israel, they have too much trouble with Rome, and all right, so is limited, is less good organized, and the Talmud that become popular, that most of the people learn, is the Talmud Bavli. Even the Talmud Yerushalmi, the Talmud of Eretz Israel, is more high. Is more Muchin de Abba, father brand.
Which one?
Yerushalmi. The Talmud Yerushalmi. The Talmud Bavli is more Mochen de Ima, mother brand.
Bavli is
Mochen de Ima. It means he gives you more, be careful of this and be careful of this. And
when period were they written?
This is by the people that wrote the Talmud, we call them Amoraim. And even he was signed, the add thing to the Talmud after, in the 600 years too, the add after Rav Ashi.
Year, like in year 600 more or less?
Yes, yes.
In parallel, Bavli and Yerushalm in the same period? More or less?
Yes. The Talmud Yerushalm is probably stop with it before. Okay, so this is what we call the Oral Torah, even it is written. And if it was not written, and we would know anything about how to do it with the small memory we have today. In the time, they used to memorize everything by heart, but today, it's really a mess. Okay, so, and the Talmud is full of story, of all kind of stuff, all kind of discussions that's about God, about the next, what to care, about anything in the world, about plants, about animal.
It's a very Kabbalistic
story. It's associative connection. They talk about something, how to do a certain thing, and for association reasons, they go to another thing. And it looks like a marsan.
Like a warehouse.
On the toll. You know, you fool the all kind of stuff. Maybe I will use it sometimes. It looks like this a little bit because it looks not organized, you know. All kind of stuff. Discussion of law and stories and completely. You can find there everything, but this really gives you teach you a lot about the life, the way the life was in the time. Because really God and all these stories, all the midrashim that are there, it's all secret. It's like a secret way of teaching. It's like a Kabbalistic way. It's like a way to teach Kabbalah in the way that for you just a story, but really hiding all the biggest secret.
A lot of insights.
In the old time, how they used to learn Kabbalah, with stories, in the way that who don't have to understand it, he understand it as a story. A cute, nice story.
Like a metaphor.
But it's all, of course, metaphor.
Allegorical stories.
Yeah.
That are about
it's
our
all,
soul.
It's
inside.
All. It's all Kabbalah, and it's not the way it look. It's very organized, even it look completely something a mess. It's everything. It's super organized in a way that it seems to be not organized. It's like a chaos, but it is the order in this chaos. It is, of course.
There's wise people, the Mekubalim, that wrote Talmud, right? Or
is Chachamim, wise people that know everything by heart,
right?
So they can, everybody can bring for his opinion. Why you think so? Because here it is written so, and here it is written so. From here I can learn so and so. All right. So this is the oral Torah. So it's like I introduced to the Christian world. Probably there are many rabbis that can explain and give much more background to what is oral Torah of me. But this about what is about. So we if not the oral Torah, we will not know anything, how to do it, how this have to be done. And if we want to understand, to have the pleasure of doing, and to understand what really hiding behind all this rule and all this action we do, for this we have to learn the Kabbalah and the Hasidut. This is another steps
of
learning.
The
it's all code, it's all everything ever.
The story is layers, pardes.
There are layers of
Shatrem,
and everything. Everything is like this.
All talking about the same thing but different languages.
Okay, so we have to bring God to all the detail that we're dealing with them in this world, that the halacha deal with this, even how to tight my shoes, in what way. We want to bring God to all the detail of life. And the Gemara get anywhere.
Everywhere.
Everywhere, get everywhere, right? But if we learn Kabbalah and we go more deep to the letter, why he mentioned this bird in this place and why he mentioned this plant in this place and why and why and why. So we get much more deep of understanding, and then this is life. This is life, it's not just will. It's not just the king says so and we have to do so. It's very nice to do what the king wants, but we have to, it's more of this. We have to live too. We have to
make sense.
We have to understand the pleasure always that is behind the will. All right. Thank
also
you.
Also bring pleasure to the creator, I guess.
And
Nachat la Borea, let's say.
We have to live.
Right.
To, if not, the Torah, if it's only outside, it's not enough to get to internal life. The idea that the really, that the tree of life, the Etz HaChaim, will give us internal life. And this is the secret of the Torah. It's not anything else.
So we can say that the Oral Torah is the soul of the Torah? Can we say that?
No.
Is that or
no.
The,
No. It's Allah. Opposite. It's a vessel.
Vessel.
It's the vessel of the receiver.
Okay.
The Oral Torah, the way you look, especially if it is written, is this the way you have to do it in a case like this and in a case like this, and I have to think about all the situation that I can think about this. The Chachamim have to think about all the different situations. But if I learn the Oral Torah the way I'm supposed to learn it, it take me to the tree of life, of course. Mm-hmm. And you have to become again an Oral Torah. It means a Torah that is part of my life. I live it.
Living Torah.
It's not something that I have to go every instant to the book to see what to do it.
Mm-hmm.
Thank you.